Now imagine this.
Yep.
You're wandering down the street.
Which street?
Any old street.
Okay, yep.
You spot a $50 bill. Ooh. Just lying on the ground.
Yes.
No one's around.
Yep.
Do you pocket it? Keep it for yourself? Buy yourself a treat?
Yes.
Or do you hand it into the police?
Well, no brainer. Personally, I'm a believer in finders, keepers, losers, weepers, but since you've asked me on national TV, I'm going to say, just for once, I'm going to hand it into the police.
That is the right thing to do.
Good choice.
But honesty doesn't always pay. Here's Garth.
Look at it, just laying there for the taking. Who could pass up a 50 on the footpath? Could you? Actually, what amazed us was the number of people who seemed oblivious and walked by, on their phones mostly, but some...
I see you found my $50.
I'm just looking for who to give it to.
Right on the money. If you found 50 bucks in the street, what would you do with it?
I'm not sure.
Ask my friend what to do with it.
What does your friend say?
Take it.
Find the person who owned it.
How would you do that?
Well, I don't know. I'll take it to the cops because it's not my money.
Would you go to the police?
I don't think so.
20, 50 bucks, 100 bucks, lent as a banknote, non-traceable to the owner. So you would waste a resource and time of the police to try to return it to the owner.
Okay, well, on the main drag into Kaufata, Robin Dobbs has wrestled with these very questions.
Flat on the ground, and I sort of did a double take, and I thought, $50 on the ground, and I thought, and I looked all around, and I thought, well, there's nobody here. I was a bit astounded, actually.
The street was almost empty, then she saw a woman and child.
So I raced after this lady, and I caught up with her further up at the shops, and I said, oh, have you lost any money? And she said, no.
50 bucks can go a long way in Waikato. Robin could have splashed out at the local hipster chutney joint. They make it all on premises and it's good. She could have taken her find across the road and blown it all on lotto tickets. After all, somebody won big here once before. But no, Robin is a straight arrow. She shot straight up the road to the cop shop.
Tried to find somebody there, but there was nobody there.
Which is good, means Te Kaufata's sole charge constable is out on the road doing the job. Robin tried again the next day She phoned.
They put me in touch with the Huntley Police Station, and I said to them, well, it's quite a fair way for me to come just to hand in $50, so will I hold it here or what will I do with it? And they said, no, we'll come and collect it.
Police took it seriously.
That morning they came up to my door.
Very seriously.
Lights and sirens on.
Oh, no.
Okay, not that seriously.
They did thank me for my honesty.
And it looked like it might pay off as well.
They said, first of all, that I could phone them up in 2 months' time, and then if there's no one had inquired about it, then I could get the money back.
Robin was patient. She has plenty to keep her busy. She knits for missions overseas.
So in 2 months, or just after the 2 months, I emailed them.
No one had claimed it, but the police wanted another month to be sure.
I contacted them again by email, and he said that he would hand it on to the sergeant.
The police had banked the money for safekeeping. Robin gave them her account number as asked. Her thoughts turned to an imminent windfall for a good deed.
I just might go to the cafe and have a nice cappuccino. It would be lovely. I could shout everybody else, couldn't I?
But the money never showed up, and it was tricky chasing up the right police officer.
I couldn't speak to him personally. They sent an email. I didn't get any response.
They are busy people.
And I know they're busy people, and I respect that, and there's a lot more going on than just $50, but it's just, I feel a principle.
She waited a few more weeks, still no money.
Hello.
Called again.
He said, overworked and underpaid. Didn't seem to be quite the right attitude to me.
It left her doubting herself.
Does it pay to be honest? I think it does pay, but this does make you wonder.
Gosh, did you wish you hadn't bothered?
Well, it could have been tempting, but I thought my conscience wouldn't let me do that.
Finders, keepers, losers, weepers. It may rhyme, but it's also a crime. Section 219 of the Crimes Act. In fact, if Robin had just slipped that 50 into her pocket to spend later, she'd have been committing theft. But should the police still be hanging on to a nifty 50 5 months later? Every case needs a break. Ours came filming part of the story at the police station just as the very busy sole charge constable happened to return.
I'm Garth.
It was the first he'd heard of it, but he got on the blower and chased it up. So it seems like these situations, it takes a couple of senior police officers to sign it off, and there's that frontline police officer who only works 2 regular day shifts out of every 10. You start to see why this can take quite a lot longer to sort out than you'd imagine. And it's a lot of trouble for $50.
Regardless, police commend Ms. Dobbs for handing in to police the $50 that she found in June. We would encourage anyone who finds cash or other valuables to follow Ms. Dobbs' example and take the items to their local police station. The time taken to return found property is dependent on the time deemed necessary to complete inquiries to locate the original owner. Police thank Ms. Dobbs for her patience as we work towards identifying the rightful owner of the cash.
Which is now Robin. She'll be getting it back any day now.
Very good, very good.
Just one thing.
Now, you understand, Robin, there's a chance that someone might see this and go, I lost $50.
If there's a person that genuinely lost the money and can prove it on the particular day that it was found, then I would willingly give it back to them.
Robin is a good person, and what's more, she says she plans to donate that $50 to the local St John Ambulance or the Westpac Rescue Helicopter
Trust.
Good
on you, Robin, and this story got us thinking. Here's a question for you now. How much money do you think the police are holding in that lost cash bank account for waiting for people to collect? How much do you reckon?
See, I'm tempted to say zero, but I'm going to say 20 grand.
20 grand? Mm-hmm. I love it when you're wrong. About the time they banked Robin's fine, there would have been almost $200,000 that the police were holding in that account waiting for the rightful owners to come forward, and it's growing at around 20 grand a year as more comes in than is actually claimed back.
Wow.